Nice to meet you. In this video, I would like to explain about Niagara's collision notification method. Along with collisions, I'll also introduce some modules that might be easy to use for barrages. I didn't see any similar information, so I think this will be helpful for making bullet games with Niagara. I will also try to explain the procedure in detail so that it is easy to understand even for Niagara beginners. I hope this will be a good opportunity for more people to touch Niagara. If you find it useful, please spread the word on social media. So let's do it. What is Niagara? Overview. Niagara is a new particle system for the Unreal Engine that was officially released with UE4 4.25 in 2020. It is a more powerful and scalable particle system than the existing Cascade particle system. After the official release, it seems that they are planning to promote Niagara, so when using particles, let's use Niagara. For effects that you have created or purchased in the past with Cascade, you can use the. There is an official plugin called Cascade to Niagara Converter, so it's not a waste of time. Difference between Cascade and Niagara. If I had to pick one major difference between Cascade and Niagara, it would be the fact that, with Cascade, if you wanted to do something complex, you had to extend the functionality in C++. In Niagara, the ability to add and edit functions in the form of nodes is a particularly significant factor. There are some other useful features, such as emitter sharing, that Cascade doesn't offer. To learn more about this area, I recommend Akeda's talk at Unreal Fest S 2018 as it is very easy to understand. I'll put a link to it in the overview section as well. Basic structure of Niagara. It is safe to assume that the traditional Cascade particles white and Niagara system red are treated equally. Just think of the items other than the FX Niagara system as things to use when you want to do something elaborate. If you just want to use the basic functions, you can create Niagara particles by creating a Niagara system. In the Niagara system, the blue one on the left is the Niagara system, and the orange one on the right is the Niagara emitter. Emitters can be added by right-clicking. From templates, you can choose a basic particle emitter. Parents will see a homemade emitter. Behavior examples shows emitters of reference examples, so you can check them when learning. Right-click on the emitter and select Create Asset from this to create the data with the emitter available for sharing. Practice creating particles with Niagara. Launch UE4 4.2 7.1. Select the third-person template and open it. I would like to start with something that many of you are familiar with. Create Niagara system. Create an FX folder and in it right-click greater than FX greater than select Niagara system. Select new system from selected emitters. This time, we will choose fountain. To select, double-click or click the green plus button to add an emitter. Press finish to create the Niagara system. I changed the name to NS_test1. Double-click on it and open it. You can see a simple fountain particle. Once confirmed, return to the viewport of the third-person template and click. Drag the created NS_test1 to the viewport and the fountain particle will be generated. If you just want to place the particles as they are, the process of creating and generating Niagara particles is now complete. Niagara Collision. Addition of Collision. First click the plus to the right of Particle Update in the fountain emitter. When you select Collision, you will see a red bicubic mark and click Fix Issue. Now, when you go back to the viewport, you will see the fountain ball bouncing on the ground in the red surprise symbol. With the caveat that the collision needs to be above the solve forces and velocity module. When I clicked on the Fix Issue button, the order was automatically changed. Necessary settings for collision notification. In the Parameters tab, click on the plus in the User Exposed System setting and select Object. Rename the created new object to BP Callback. Next, click the plus to the right of Particle Update, search for blue, and click Export Particle Data to Blueprint Added. You will see a warning sign with a blue surprise mark. To understand this feature, please check out content examples. This is a note that says, if you want to remove the blue surprise mark, press dismiss. You can also leave it alone. When export particle data to blueprint is selected, the detailed view of the. Click the lower triangle to the right of condition to export data, search for collision, and then click, select collision valid from output and collision. Now we have a configuration where this module will react when something collides with it. The settings for where to send the response are. In the callback handler parameter tab, specify the BP callback that you just created here. Now we have the minimum configuration for the Niagara side. Call Niagara on actor. In order to notify collisions of collisions, we will not put a Niagara system as it is but prepare an actor. From the right-click menu, select Blueprint Class Actor, and then select BP_Niagara_Test1. Double-click on BP_Niagara_Test1 to open it and select Niagara Particle System from plus Add Component in the upper left corner. Select the added Niagara and specify NS underscore test 1 inch as the Niagara system asset in the details field. Collision event blueprint settings. In the event graph screen, right-click to search and invoke the set Niagara variable object node. Connect event begin play. Type BP callback in the invariable name field. Apply self to the object field. Next, with class settings selected, click select interfaces greater than implemented interfaces from the add menu of the do a search for Niagara and select Niagara particle callback handler. Once you have done that, compile and save the file. In the lower left corner in the interfaces column, right click on Niagara greater than receive particle data and select implement event. Prepare event receive particle data. Connect a print string to it and check if hello is called. Remove the Niagara system that is directly on the level and drag in the blueprint you created. When you play, hello will appear on the left side of the screen. We have now confirmed that the collision event is sent to the actor. Send damage to the player. In the default collision setting, world dynamic is selected and it takes a collision check for everything. I would like to make this a collision detection only for the player. Project settings, add trace channel. Project settings. In engine, collision, trace channels, select new trace channel. Change name to enemy projectile, select ignore for default response, and press accept. We now have a new trace channel to use. Specify collision trace channel. Open Niagara NS underscore test 1 and select collision and CPU collision trace channel. Set enemy projectile, player side collision settings. Next, configure the player side settings by opening third person character and selecting set collision presets in mesh 2 custom. Change enemy projectile in the trace pay responses section to a block. For simplicity, this is now in a state where it only collides with the player. Damage sending process. Then, in Niagara's actor blueprint, send apply damage to get player pawn. In the player's blueprint, if you assemble and event any damage, the damage will be sent to you. That's it for the basic structure of the collision detection on the player side. I want to erase the impacted bullets. Currently, after a bullet hits a player, it may bounce and hit a player multiple times. I would like to set it to disappear upon collision. Click the plus to the right of particle update in NS underscore test 1. Do a search on kill and add kill particles. Click on the lower triangle to the right of kill particles and search for collision. Select output collision and collision valid. This will process the collision and then disappear. I want to deal damage to non-players. If you just want to hit the player with the enemy's bullets, you can get by with just specifying the trace channel. If you are dealing damage to an unspecified number of people, you will not know where the damage is being sent. I would like to trace again in actor's blueprint what it collided with. Niagara export particle data to blueprint settings. First, select export particle data to blueprint for Niagara NS underscore test 1 and click drag particles precious and position to vector to send a struct position and then click drag particles precious and velocity to vector to send a struct velocity. Specify transient and collision size for float to send a struct size by searching for collision. Trace settings in actor. Open the actor BP underscore Niagara underscore test 1 for Niagara and pull to the right from data to create a for each loop. Expand the array element with break and then click. Use position, size, and velocity to set a sphere trace by channel. The hit actor in the trace result can be applied to apply damage. Now we have a process that sends damage to an unspecified number of colliding objects. This is one of the methodologies. If you have a better way, please share it with us. I want to generate particles at the location of the collision. I'm also going to do how to set it up if I want to have a collision effect. Generate collision event. It is used to send the event that caused the collision to another emitter. When you add this module, you will see a warning text with a red surprise symbol. Check out the Niagara log. I'm just confirming that you need to enable particle ID and that it's okay if the process is a little heavy. Requires persistent IDs. If you check the requires persistent IDs checkbox, the red surprise mark and warning texts will disappear. New emitters added. Right click on add emitter and select fountain. You can use a different emitter, but we choose this one because we think it will be less confusing than adding an emitter we don't know. Event handler properties. Click on the plus sign of the event handler to add a property. Set source to collision event. Set spawn number to 30. Receive collision event. Click on the plus to the right of the event handler again and search for collision. Add receive collision event. Now, particles will be generated where the collision occurred. Remove spawn rate. Remove the spawn rate as it will cause particles to be generated in places other than collisions. Collision check. The particles are colored red to make them easier to identify as particles after a collision. I think we need to make some adjustments. This is the procedure for generating particles at the collision location using the event handler. how to make a Niagara Barrage, how to fly regularly. Create a new Niagara system. Choose empty to create an S_test 2. Particle spawn settings. Spawn burst instantaneous. Since empty is an empty emitter, we will first add a spawn module to generate particles. Spawn burst instantaneous. With this module, a specified number of particles will be generated at a specified position in the first frame. Let's set the spawn count to 32. At this point, you can see a single point in the center of the emitter, but the 32 particles are shown overlapping each other. From here, place the particles in regular positions. Arrange the particles in a regular pattern. By adding the location module, you can adjust the position of the particle generation. We will pick up a few modules that are easy to arrange in a regular way. Sphere location. Useful when arranging in a spherical shape. Set the sphere distribution to uniform. The default state generates particles at the vertices of a regular polygon. By changing the value of uniform spiral amount, you can change the pattern of the array. You can create more variations by changing other values. The particle size was a little too large. Sprite size mode of initialize particle is changed to uniform. Grid location. Useful for neatly arranging in a square grid. Add grid location to create spawn particles in grid and adjust the number of particles here. In the grid location section, you can adjust the spacing and other settings. Tourist location. Useful when arranging in a ring shape. Set tourist mode to ring. Set tourist distribution mode to direct. Do a search for index in the U position and find. By specifying the return normalized exact index, you can get a nice ring shape. To create your own module. If you double-click on each module, you can see its structure. You can check the contents of modules that are similar to what you want to do and create your own modules. You can create your own modules if they are missing from the standard ones. Make particles fly in a regular pattern. If you're done with the regular layout and want to fly easy, you can use the emitter state. First, change the emitter state from system to self. Set loop duration to 0.1. This will cause a particle to be generated every 0.1 seconds. Add velocity from point. Add velocity from point allows you to move the particle at a certain velocity from the center. When you add velocity from point, you will see a warning message. Solve forces velocity is needed. So, when I press fix problem, I get solve forces velocity will be created automatically. These are the basics of how to fly regularly. Expression. There is a way to control it by typing expression directly. If you don't have the time to create a modular script, you can use expression to create behavior that cannot be done by just typing numbers. The math expression note in the official documentation can also be helpful. With a simple expression, I would like to rotate the emitter. In tourist location, click the lower triangle to the right of normalized angle around tourist axis and then click. Select new expression. To test this, type emitter age *0.1. This will cause the emitter to rotate. Emitter age is useful because you can easily create a value that changes with time by multiplying it by something. I'll post an article that will be posted at the same time as this video and a sample project on GitHub. I hope you will check there as well. Niagara sample data. With the above basics in mind, check out the Niagara_sample data from the link in the overview section. I have placed a slightly more detailed version of the process than the one described here. If you're an intermediate or higher level user, you can probably tell just by looking at the data. If you are a Niagara beginner, it would be easier to understand the video and touch it. If you prefer text information, we have prepared an article for you as well. In addition, the information presented here is the result of my own verification of the data and content examples. In order to learn more about Niagara, I think it would be good to understand the current content examples. As for the fireworks and other gimmicks, Mamiosen has released sample data. You may also find this helpful. As for the look of Niagara, there are people on YouTube who have shared information with me. If you do a search, you'll find many ways to make it look gorgeous. When I started looking for information on Niagara, I was troubled by the lack of information on collisions. I'd like to share information and, to some extent, make it easier for everyone to make these. Okay, thanks for your time. This is the first time I've made an English version of a video. How was it? If you find it useful, please comment, rate it highly, or subscribe to the channel. So, please watch the next video. Thank you for watching.